Welcome back, trainers, and as you can see here, I did pick the green version for the Kanto event. Looking good, already discussed that, but what we're going to be really going over in this video is all of the lucky Pokemon that I obtained during level 48, and I'm going to tell you right now, that was so annoying, like, really, and I want to give a big thank you to everybody who did send me a friend request when I did put my code out on Twitter so I can add you and then send you a gift. I'm sorry if you're not able to open that. I was just trying to get through it as fast as possible. So as you can see here, the legendary catch is no big deal. Going up against the Rocket Leaders with 2500 CP is the easiest thing ever. But the 999 excellent throws is ridiculous. Give me a break. So I got the boots that I wanted. These are so fresh. Loving them. So as far as the catches are concerned, these excellent throws, I'm just going to basically do as many legendary raids as possible. I'm going to go out and grind, but I have a lot of stuff happening in the next couple of days, and I'm not going to be moving away from that to do this task or to get the 999 throws so I could be the first one in Alaska to beat a 50. There is somebody who's slightly ahead of me, so, you know, more power to them. Hopefully you're able to get that as soon as possible, but I don't care. we'll make it second, third, whatever it is. Nonetheless, these lucky trades. Now I'm going to tell you how this went down here. Holy cow, it was so tedious. And I gave up so many of my good Pokemon from back in the day. So I did meet up with several different people, as well as somebody actually meeting up with me to do a bunch of trades and all that stuff. So we're going to look at that here. We were able to obtain some legacies, and you're not going to believe this, guys. Just wait for the grand finale here, the final lucky Pokemon that we did receive, and I haven't even put this out on Twitter yet. I said we received a 100 good Pokemon, I didn't say what it was, but I can't believe it. With my son, the last trade, I gave up one of my old mucks, Falu, if you do remember, had it maxed out for a while, and it became lucky in 100. Oh my god, I can't believe it. So, met up with some people. And we did those trades. They had some 2016, and I would just give them some Pokemon, and we would get those underway here. So 50, maybe you know several people that do have a bunch of 2016 Pokemon that haven't done a single trade, so you're going to be able to get those guaranteed 10 lucky Pokemon right off the bat from this 2016, and then you can keep trading 2016 to have a very high chance for it to go lucky, and you're probably able to finish that no problem if you are at this specific level here. But for me, it was a little bit harder. You know, we had some people really helping us out, and I really appreciate everybody's support. So we were able to get this done. But man, when they ran out of Pokemon, and you also have a limit for the day, which the limit is not a big deal. I don't really care about that. But when you're getting all these old Pokemon and they just keep staying normal, you're like, what's going on? Come on now. And this is also a legacy Poliwrath with that submission. It's not going to be great. But it is a legacy nonetheless. You start getting a little nervous. And what happened was I exhausted all of my friends. We could have met up with more people. We had a lot of people offering to help us out locally for their 2016s they said they had. So we could have gotten it done, but it would have required me having people to go out and meet. And I don't really like to do that. I don't like making people going out to meet me somewhere. I mean, if they are lucky friends, you know, like, hey, do you want to meet up? Of course they, you know, sure, we can do it or do a different day. That's a different story. But, you know, just for my, I wouldn't call my soul self-interest. I mean, technically it is. I'm trying to get lucky Pokemon. But if they're offering to help after I did ask, then hey, sure, let's go ahead and do it. So I just kind of basically wanted to almost get this done myself here. So my son's account, he doesn't really play much anymore. Unfortunately, he's just not into it. But before we go down that route, I accidentally bought a second move on this when I was trading with a friend. And it wasn't even lucky, but it turned out to have, I guess, IVs for PvP. Probably not the most ideal, but at least we bought the secondary move on this one and not some sort of 98 lucky one like this, which is not a 98, but it has good IVs, not ideal. But anyways, back onto the topic we were discussing here with my son's account. Unfortunately, he's not really into it anymore. It's just what it is. You know, his dad's sitting here playing it all the time. He probably doesn't care, right? We actually hatched this Noibat as well. So he did have some 2020 Pokemon, which we did trade, and I guess it helped. We got a few luckies out of his account total without me trading my old 2016s to him, which we'll go over here in just a moment. Just me giving him just Pokemon I recently caught. For his Pokemon, we probably got around 15 to 16 luckies on that account. So, you know, not bad. And then eventually I just started to have to trade my 2016s. I could have totally met up if I was patient with other people throughout the week and traded them their 2016s. We could have sat there for 20 minutes. It's just trading. But now, you know, meeting them is one thing, but sitting there and trying to get lucky Pokemon with their 2016s for 30 minutes in Anchorage is not, you know, the best idea around. I mean, it's not horrible, but I just, like I said, I don't like having people wait on me. All right. So we were able to get that Dodrio. That's like our third lucky one for some reason. And have you seen the Cub Chews? I don't know what's going on with this. The Cub Chews are crazy. And I guess if you looked at it from the statistic point of view, and you're like, well, you're probably catching a bunch of Cub Chews. That's what you had in your inventory to trade. Well, actually, no, we had a lot of other Pokemon too. That one is just kept turning out to be lucky. It was funny. I was like, when I started to get annoyed, I would just go to the Cub Chews, and what do you know? Lo and behold, it would turn out to be lucky. And there you go, folks. Grand finale, shabam. That was the last trade I did for my 2016 muck. Traded it with my son. He had a Gible, and it turned out to be a freaking 100. Look at this. We're going to buy a secondary move. Simple as that. I'm not going to max it out right now because we already do have a level 40 Gible, two moves, which we did use in the Great League, by the way, and we did win. So I can't believe it. Out of all the trades, the very last one is going to be the 100. So that's a nice way to go out. This was the final thing I needed to do. At this point, I had sent out all the gifts already, and that was, you know, that wasn't too big of a deal. It was just very tedious, right? So final trade. Are you kidding me? And then we were able to get this Beldum here. Speaking of that Beldum, one of the tasks for level 49 to 50 is going to be beating Team Go Rocket leaders with 2,500 CP or less. Forget that. Like we discussed, we're doing 1,500 CP. I mean, what? Come on, man. This is like one of the final challenges. What happened to 1,500? Anyways, we're going to do it ourselves. Going in there with the regular shiny Mawile, not the shadow. Putting on some damage and swapping into Sirfetch. Now, if you're looking at the Pokemon Arlo does have with the Pokemon that I do currently have, you're probably thinking you totally went in here beforehand and saw what they had. Now, I would not lie to you. I mean, what's the point? I would tell you. I always do if I do go in there beforehand and see what they are. But I didn't. I just got lucky. I just picked the Pokemon according to what Arlo could have and hopefully just lined up correctly. And if it didn't have the correct lineup for it, I would have just picked a different team. But I find it quite incredible that I'm actually able to go in here with 1500 CP and just wipe him out in the first try here without even seeing the Pokemon. So there you have it. Looking good here, Sirfetch'd. Putting in the work. Look at this sucker. Look at that. Awesome. So level 49, pretty cool. We're sitting in the 49th state here in Alaska. So that's pretty awesome as well. And here we go. Got my boots. I'm happy. We're looking fantastic. If you did enjoy this video, give it a big thumbs up. Just a little update on my progress here to level 49. And I'll be keeping you up to date on everything Pokemon Go and bringing you some more battles. Thanks for watching and take care.